In this video, we are going to make an oval speech bubble. If you want to follow along, you can find the download link for the image in the video description. When we have opened our image, we will start by making a new layer. Press Ctrl+Shift+N to make a new layer and name it Speech Bubble. Leave the fill type transparent and click OK. Press E on your keyboard to make the Ellipse Select tool active. Make an oval selection where you want the text bubble to come. Then press the B key to make the Paths tool active. Click 3 points to make the shape of a triangle and then hover over the first point. Press and hold the Ctrl key and when you see a connect sign, you click so the triangle is closed. Check the option Edit in the toolbox. Click and drag the first straight line to bend it a little, as shown in the video. Then we do the same with the other line, just click and drag. Now we press and hold the Shift key and click on the button Selection from Path. Go to Select and click To Path. Then we go back to Edit and hit Fill with Background Color. Click Edit again and hit Stroke Path. We stroke the path instead of the selection because in this way our lines will look much better. Make the line width 20 and click Stroke. Then to select and here we hit None. Now we click a random tool in the toolbox to make the path invisible and there we have our speech bubble. Press T on your keyboard to activate the text tool. Triple click on the font name and type in the font you want to use. I've chosen for the font MV Boli. Change the size to 50. Now we drag out the framework where we want to have text. Then type in your text. When we hover over the font icon in the toolbox and roll the mouse wheel, we can see different fonts pass by, so that's an easy way to choose a font. Now we select the text by click and drag and adjust its size by clicking the triangles. Deselect the text by clicking it. Go to the toolbox and adjust the spacing between the lines. Then we use the corners and or the handles of the framework to reposition the text. To finish off, we go to Image and hit Flatten Image. And there we have it, a nice oval text bubble. I hope this helps and if that's the case, please don't forget to like, subscribe and leave a nice comment to support my channel. Thanks very much for watching.